Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll be explaining you radar range calculation based on noise figure of receiver. In my last video, I have explained you radar range calculation for minimum detectable signal. In this video, I'll be explaining you radar range calculation based on noise figure of receiver. So first of all, you need to understand what is noise figure. See, noise figure is SNR at input divided by SNR at output. Here, with this receiver, we need to identify signal to noise ratio at input divided by signal to noise ratio at output. That is noise figure. So let me explain you that noise figure, that is denoted by F, and that is SNR at input divided by SNR at output. Signal to noise ratio at input is signal power at input divided by noise power at input, and SNR at output, that is signal power at output divided by noise power at output. Here this N0, that will go in numerator, so SI into N0 will be there, and in denominator we will be having signal at output and noise at input. Now we need to understand how this SNR is there with receiver. See, here we have signal power at input side and noise power at input side. Now here at output side, we will be having signal power at output and noise power at output. If you want to calculate signal power at output, then here with receiver gain is G and noise of receiver, that is delta N. So here signal power of input into gain, that is S0, right? And along with that, along with this, this delta N, that is the noise of receiver that is getting added, and N0, that will be gain of receiver into noise at input. So G into NI, along with that, this delta N that is getting added, which is noise of receiver. See here, signal power of output, that is having G SI plus delta N. Here, this delta N value, that is very small compared to G into SI. So here we can neglect this. The reason is value of signal into gain, that is way higher compared to delta N. So here this delta N, that is negligible. So you can say S0, that is G into SI only, while here N0 is G NI plus delta N, where this delta N is not negligible. The reason is this delta N, that is comparable compared to G into NI, right? Now we will be placing these values in this equation to get the value of noise figure. So here noise figure that I have told you, that is F, that is SI into N0, right? Here SI, that is as it is, but N0, that is G NI plus delta N, and here this SO, that is GSI only, so G into SI, and here NI, that will be as it is. Now, if you carefully observe this, then in this, this SI that is getting cancelled, right? And we can further simplify this equation. You see F is equals to, see, GNI divided by GNI, that will be 1, plus delta N divided by G and I. Now we can further simplify this. Based on that, we can have value of delta N. So if you take this one on other side, you'll be having F minus 1, that is equals to delta N divided by G and I. Here, based on this, we can have delta N, that is noise added by receiver, that will be F minus 1 into G and I, where NI, that is noise at input side. See here, NI, that is noise at input side, right? And this noise at input, that is purely based on temperature, and its value is KB into T. Let me explain you that. So noise at input, that is K into T into B, where this K is Boltzmann's constant this T naught, that is temperature in terms of Kelvin, and B is bandwidth of the received signal, right? Value of Boltzmann's constant, that is 1.38 into 10 to the power minus 23 in SI, right? So by placing these values, one can identify noise at input. So if you increase temperature, noise at input will increase. And as per this equation, KT0 into B, one can identify noise at input. Now, we just need to place this in this equation to get the value of delta N. The reason is delta N, that is noise of receiver, right? So here, delta N value will be this Ni, that is KT0 into B, right? So this is what noise added by receiver. Now one should know, if you want to detect signal, then noise added by receiver, see, noise of receiver, that is delta N. Then noise of receiver, obviously that should be lower than minimum detectable signal. See, in my last video, I have explained you maximum range of radar, in which S min, that is minimum detectable signal. So here, minimum detectable signal, that is what reflected EM wave that is coming at this antenna. So that minimum detectable signal, that should be always greater than noise added by receiver in this radar system, right? So here, for proper operation of radar, it is very compulsory that this delta N, that should be lower than S min. Value of delta N, that should be lower than S min for proper operation of radar, right? Now here, what we will be doing is, we will be calculating radar range by considering S min is equals to delta N. See, this S min is equals to delta N, that is threshold of reception of received signal, right? Obviously, delta N should be lower than S min, but as if delta N is equals to S min, then that is what threshold of reception of signal, where you will be having maximum range, right? So here, this delta N, that I'll be substituting as per delta N is equals to S min in the equation which I have derived it in my last video. So this is the equation in which I'll be substituting S min is equals to delta N. Now let us substitute S min is equals to delta N, that is this, in this equation. So your radar range equation, that will be modified to, here instead of S min, I need to substitute this, that is F minus 1 into G into K into T naught into bandwidth raised to 1/4. So this is what maximum range of radar in terms of noise figure. Now here, usually with radar system, you will be observing, we are using parabolic dish antenna, right? So for parabolic dish antenna, one should know what is effective area AE. 0.65 pi d² / 4. If you substitute that in this equation, as well as if you consider T naught at room temperature, which is 300 Kelvin, and if you substitute values of Boltzmann's constant, gain, and all those parameters, then you can modify your radar range equation. If you place the values as I have mentioned it over here, your radar range equation for maximum range, that will get changes to 48 into PT D to the power 4 sigma divided by bandwidth lambda square into noise figure minus 1/4. So this is what the equation of radar range, which is there based on noise figure. Here, if you observe in this basic equation of radar range based on noise figure, here in denominator, we have F minus 1. So I have seen students are saying me like, what if sir, this F is equals to 1, then radar range will become infinite. But remember, this noise figure, that cannot be unity, it is always greater than 1. The reason is, always here at input, somewhat noise will be there, right? As somewhat noise is there over here, SNR at input divided by SNR at output cannot be equal to 1. It will be always greater than 1, right? So here, this value of F, that cannot be equals to 1 due to noise at input of receiver, right? One more thing that you should know. See, if you want to optimize radar range, then here in radar, you can use anti-jamming techniques. In anti-jamming techniques, what we can do is we can use frequency hopping. So by changing frequency with respect to time, we can have optimization of radar range where we can reduce noise at input. See, usually noise at input that comes by enemy, right? If they provide you jammer, then they will be radiating random frequencies at that time. Enemy's vehicle that will be transmitting noise to the radar. So radar cannot identify unknown objects. So at radar side, if you provide anti-jamming technique in which you will be changing frequency with respect to time, that is referred as frequency hopping, by which you can optimize radar range, right? So to optimize signal at input side, we can use anti-jamming light, frequency hopping, spread spectrum, that is referred as FHSS. So this is basic equation of radar range based on noise figure. In future coming videos, I'll be solving some examples based on radar range. I hope you have understood this. Still, if anything that you like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.